A few weeks ago, I deleted Windows from my computer, completely. And if you miss the story, Windows tried to upload my personal files to OneDrive without my consent. And that was it. I was done, so I fully switched to Linux. And you know what happened? For the first time in years, I felt like I owned my computer again. No forced updates interrupting my work. No corporate boot screens. No telemetry sending data I cannot see. And no AI assistant that I never asked for. I could customize everything. The desktop, the workflow, even how the system boots. Just pure freedom. But here's the thing about Linux. It comes with a critical choice you have to make on day one. And now, full transparency. I have been using Linux since 1998, over 25 years. So my path is going to look different from yours. But here's what I learned in those 25 years. Linux isn't one thing, it's a spectrum of choices. And the beautiful part, you get to decide how deep you want to go. I'm going to show you my choice, not because you should copy it, but so you understand what's possible. But first, let me acknowledge something really important. For the last few years, I have been renting. Think of Microsoft and Apple as landlords. They give you a beautiful, fully furnished, luxury apartment. It's easy and it's convenient, but you can't change the locks. And they keep the master key. They can come in anytime they want and rearrange everything. Installing Linux, on the other hand, is like deciding who owns your home. But that's where the real choice begins. You have to decide what kind of owner you want to be. And using this analogy, we have, let's say, the move-in ready home. This includes distributions like Ubuntu, Mint, and Fedora. This is the path for most of the people. You get a working system out of the box. These distributions are fantastic. They are the easiest path to digital freedom. And yes, Ubuntu and Fedora are backed by corporations with their own interests, but they are still 1,000 times better than Windows for privacy and control. And for many people, this is exactly where they should start, and maybe also where they will stay, and that's perfectly fine. Then we have the build-it-yourself home. This includes distributions like Arch, Gentoo, and Debian. You get, let's say, the raw materials and the blueprints. You build everything yourself. It's harder, but you know every single piece of your new home. Which path did I choose? I chose to build from the ground up. I chose Artix, which is a distribution based on Arch without systemd. It's hardcore, it's do-it-yourself, and to this day I'm still configuring and tuning things. But for me, it's really worth it. Now, I'm not also suggesting you should follow this exact path. This is my journey as someone who has been doing this since 1998. But I am showing it to you so you can understand the spectrum of choice and maybe it inspires your own. So what really happened after I deleted Windows? For the first time, my computer is silent. There are no pop-ups. There are no updates I didn't ask for. There is nothing syncing to a corporate server in the background. My computer is truly mine. I finally have peace and I finally have total control. And this isn't the end. This is day one. I have built the foundation, but the house, let's say, is empty. Now the real work begins. Configuring my desktop, building my own cloud storage, my own email server, my own ecosystem for digital freedom, piece by piece. And whether you are on Ubuntu, Arch, or still on Windows, wondering if you should switch, if you want to see what's possible when you own your digital life, subscribe, because this journey is for anyone who's tired of being a tenant in their own computer. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.